Sustainability in a declining market where there is a lot of pressure on sort of revenue and costs. We have still continued our journey towards sustainability. We have become, you know, single-use plastic free. And the most exciting thing for me was our director of engineering was awarded the sustainability champion by DTCM. So it shows that we're going in the right direction. By October this year, October-November this year, we'll have our second property opening, Taj Jumeirah Lakes Towers, a 200-room property with some exciting food and beverage there. And Q1 of next year, we're looking at opening our third hotel in Dubai on the Palm. So it is going to be Taj Exotica Resort and Spa, the Palm. We are also working on a Dera project, which is expected to open in another 2 years, right on the waterfront and on the creek. And of course, our property in Mecca, which is another 2-3 years away. It's under construction. So these are some which are immediately on the pipeline, very exciting times. And we're also looking at increasing our footprint in the Middle East as a whole. So we are looking at opportunities in whether it's in Abu Dhabi, in Oman, and, you know, in places like that, in Riyadh. So we are looking at expanding our footprint also in the future. No, I think it's good. I think in any country, the priority has to be given to the people living there. I agree with that. But also what I have seen when I've traveled, I've seen that certain levels are where you either Omanize or you know, as you said, make it all Saudi. But you have certain positions which drive that business in, and I think that is fine. It doesn't concern me per se. 2 years ago for Taj Dubai, we had nothing from China. So we did our whole strategy towards China. And in our first year of, or second year of operation, we got started getting in a lot of Chinese business. And over the last couple of years, we've sort of streamlined it in such a way that we're getting the high paying Chinese guests. So that is one market which is definitely doing well for us. It has come into our top five. India is a no brainer. I mean, being an Indian company, we still have a lot of influential Indians who travel into Dubai and onwards. So that is another market that we are sort of strongly banking on. We have great sort of market accessibility in Australia and Brazil. So those are two markets that have done extremely well for us. So even though they seem far away, with Emirates connectivity, it has helped us. Well, it has been an exciting year. There has been a lot of demand and supply issues in Dubai, but we focused on things that we can control. So overall, revenue-wise, we've done extremely well. Yes, there is pressure on the room revenues, but we've focused on our food and beverage. And our food and beverage has shown a tremendous growth of almost 5% over previous year. So that has been great. The other thing that we've done very consciously is looked at new markets so that we can sort of still bring in the business into the hotel. And by doing all that, we managed to keep our STR ranking at 111, which is where we are getting our fair share in the market. The other parameter that I like to look at, and not many people speak about, is our guest satisfaction and our employee satisfaction. So one part is the financials, where we've done well, revenues have been good. The other part is our guest satisfaction has been great. Our whole philosophy of Tajness has sort of held ground in the market, and we've grown about 5% on our guest satisfaction rating. And the key indicator, you know, I've always said that it's our people who make a difference, and our attrition is down, which shows that they're happy. And when I have happy staff, they look after my guests and I have happy guests. So overall, it's been a good, challenging year, but an exciting year. As I said, the whole pressure on rates has been, it seems like there's a rate war out there. One of the things that we have consciously done is not drop our rates too much. We've said, let us instead go and look for new business. What is out there in the market? Let's bring that in. So we've sort of employed a strategy of driving occupancies. The rate, unfortunately, is not that much in our hand because that's what the market is doing. But we've sort of been able to maintain our rates by looking at emerging markets, getting new business in, and that way driving occupancy and bringing profitability in. I think the fact that as a hotel, we've worked towards our company's aspiration 2022, where we've brought in revenue growth, controlled our costs, and brought in positive EBITDA, has been one of our biggest achievements this year. Well, isn't that the million-dollar question? And I think it's a question which is on a lot of people's minds. But how I look at it is, you know, we can sort of only do what we do best. And I keep telling my team, let's focus on the guests who are coming in, let's drive our reputation, expand our footprint, And the way I've seen DTCM, the way they work, the Dubai government, they come up with something new all the time, and I'm quite sure that they will come up with a new plan and we'll be in a good place. So I think Expo will give us that impetus that we need, and I'm sure something will come out and we will survive it, as they say.